Hello, everybody.
Hello.
I'm Shaw.
And I'm Pixel Cheesecake. We're going to be playing a brand new game hot off the printing presses from Shotgun Games and Fusion 2.5.
Shotgun Anaconda.
Fun.
The game is called Velocity Noodle.
You said it was like Katana Zero.
Yep. Hey, if you union crap made this, you need to give me a refresher on your delivery training.
Why? I've been doing this for a while now.
Don't blame you, okay? Apparently, experienced people also forget stuff. First things first, the city has gone to shit. There's a bunch of crap all over the place. Press the jump button to jump. If you press it again in the air, you double jump. Boom.
Bye.
Good job on the last game. What now? I just wanted to remind you that you can dash while on the ground. You press the same button in the air you do an air dash. Use that to cross distances and get into holes.
Oh, I see. You have to dash over the pit. Ooh, want me to try?
One more time.
Nice.
Passing and have fun in our silly delivery noodle delivery game.
Right at the peak of your, right before the peak of your jump, second jump.
I think they want you to slide under that.
Yeah. For goodness sake. How many more lessons do you have?
Almost there, don't worry. The really is all about speed, so sometimes you can't wait for goals to regulate back. Plus, access card costs money, and I'm not buying any of that. Jump into a wall and you can wall slide.
Wall jumps, I know. Yada yada. Quickly press away from the wall and jump wall. Jumping wall boost, yada. I think he jumped over that. Well, slide.
What button was it again?
ZL ball.
Yeah. That's yeah.
Some guy think the ZL ones are the bumpers and not the triggers.
I think you jump over that. You got this.
This is where the fun starts. Throw your sword into the electric energy boxes, and you will teleport to it like magic. You never told me where you got that sword. I should have asked during your interview.
And I won't.
Yeah, I think this game's a little louder than most games, so I'll just
turn it down.
We were playing like head-to-head casual drop games and atmospheric games. This is the high. This is a high-paced game, so it has high-paced music.
Yeah.
That like there, that's what I was thinking of.
Nice. Hello?
What?
You didn't call.
Oh, well, there's nothing more to teach you. Use dash, air dash, sliding, and teleport to get around. Sometimes we will have to combo moves. I suggest you get comfortable with jumping and teleporting.
Okay.
Sometimes I get my buttons mixed up.
Nice. I think I understand the route.
Dude, that would shoot me up if it's not. It's not really doing that. I think you can jump like. If you like, after you teleport, you can jump, and then that's what you're supposed to do.
You saw what I was trying to do there.
I think so. I think that these bounce pads are necessary for the run.
Surprised I actually got away with that one.
Just a reminder, speed is key. You can redo deliveries to get gold times. You can always progress if you beat the level, no matter the time. Getting enough miles will unlock harder difficulty deliveries.
Sounds a bit hard.
No need to beat yourself up on the first go. Focus on learning moves and combining them. And have fun.
Have fun. Who are you?
Took a course in employee management. It's stupid.
Okay. Yikes forever. I would say double jump at that point.
Let's keep jumping into that annoying block.
Someone made a Super Meat Boy level for Pixel Artist. You got this one.
That's why it's so dear that last time.
You got this, man. Nice. Movement graduation. I realized we don't really have a set system for our recordings. Do you have an ideal length in terms of video? Your favorite sound effect.
Yep.
I think. So, throwing your sword stalls you in the air.
I think so.
Thank you. got this. Wall jump using that.
Any new stories you're interested in?
The one game got the Mario movie got hit the Billy Club, the first movie to make a billion. I thought it would have been Scream 6, because that would have been the perfect way to end that franchise, like Halloween ended the way it did.
I don't think any of these franchises are going to end.
Halloween Ends ended how the Halloween.
Well, it ended that trilogy, but there's still going to be.
You can't do it without Jamie Lee. I'll tell you that much.
I project a fourth movie that will be called Halloween.
Maybe like a I'll go as far as a sequel.
And I'll say that we'll just get, at one point we're just going to get another straight up remake.
No, like a prequel. It's called Hallow's Eve, and Jamie Lee Curtis is great, 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 great grandmother.
Mm-hmm.
Survives a woodsman who her descendants burned, like. So she has to survive off of the land around her.
I said just, 2030 or whatever. That's gonna be. Hey, there's a movie. It's a Halloween remake. It's the first one, but just set in the current day.
Yeah, no one's going to actually do that. Jamie Lee Curtis kind of made sure of that.
You know what happens in the entertainment business. The one person dies who is like who has the integrity, and then
how many How many people have been playing D&D recently because Wizards of the Coast did what they did?
Same amount of people.
Mm.
But they just switched over to things like Pathfinder.
Yeah, that's just it. They switched over to a better system with a less toxic nonsense.
Did you see that Wizards of the Coast basically said that half-breeds are racist?
Yeah, I love playing like half-orcs, half-elves, all that. Like, I don't think you can climb up that high.
Oh. Of the Coast said said half-breeds are racist, so now there can be no now there can be no race mixing.
Yeah, I don't think Wizards realized what they did when they did that. Said that. Sweet recovery.
Trying to think of
and honestly, apparently they're gonna put Chris Pratt in it as a bard. Like, how many more Lego minifigures does Chris Pratt need?
Wasn't it the Chris Pine who plays the bard, the rogue or whatever in the new movie?
No idea.
To be honest, I didn't even know.
Honestly, there was like a good version of D&D done up with puppets, but they had a female dragonborn. And you know what dragonborns are?
Hot.
Dragons. So they have larger chest for the ability to do the shit they do, like, you know, breathe fire.
No, they're Italian. There's a reason for them to have booba.
It's not even boobs, it's like a chest. Just, you know how Dwayne The Rock Johnson's chest? The word you said.
I'm sure there are plenty of people already doing that.
Fair, but still not.
We live on the internet. You can't say that nobody's doing a thing.
want to call it after this level?
Sure.
Nintendo attempted to defend its
one thing for one thing I learned like and think like only like a year or so ago, like you know pretty recently. It's like that I didn't really know that D&D had like stories. I thought it just like gave you settings and you know mechanics and you made the story.
Gary Gygax and his friends who were dads of kids got bored of poker, so they decided to make up their world. A world of fantasy. A world of Dungeons and Dragons. Then they taught their kids because sparkling math rocks teach math better than school. And then some voice actors found it. Nothing against Matt Mercer. I'm sure he's a lovely guy.
So they created the world and then they bullied their children with tobacco. I only got tired, but my sword abandoned me. Thaco? To hit armor class 0.
Oh yeah, that was the old school. My dad and my brother played that. Dad ran the game. I ran a couple characters, X ran a couple characters. Yeah, I was a nerd. Neon starting to drive me up a wall.
I thought up the perfect idea for D&D gaming night.
Yeah.
Step one is you get two pair of dice made. One is weighted so that you always get nat 20s, and the other is just regular dice. And then you learn a sleight of hand so that when you really need a nat 20, you can just swap out the dice and get it.
Mm-hmm. Why are there so many buzzsaws in this city? Like,
this is the buzzsaw district.
The buzzcut district, I would understand, but the buzzsaw district.
Buzzsaw district is filled with buzzsaws. The buzzcut district is filled with lesbians.
Ah, Chicago. Wait, San Francisco.
Finally!
Nice. Thank you for watching another episode of Gaming with Shala. He's been Shala at the helm.
But almost everything is lava.
That tracks.
But maybe we'll return to this, maybe not.
Let us know in the comments below if you'd like to see more.
But for now, bye-bye.
Bye-bye now.